Hello everybody and welcome to Dark DJ Productions. I thought I'd sing myself in today because I don't know. Anyway, hello everyone and welcome to Dark DJ Productions. And today you're looking at what we're looking at today. This is the Caledonian Railway William Pickersgill designed 191 Class 460. This has been made by our friends at Caledonia Works. Well, our friend at Caledonia Works, because it's just one dude, it's just Chris. So what is it we're looking at? This is a 460 built for the Caledonian. It is a bit of a special locomotive in a way, because it was the last locomotive designed for the Caledonian Railway before it was put into the LMS. And it's also William Pickersgill's final locomotive design for the Caledonian Railway, obviously. So what were these things? There was only a couple of them built. For one thing, they were built by North British in 1922, and they were built mainly to work on the Callander and Oban line. So they were known as the New Oban Bogie because they replaced an older class of locomotive, even though they did work on other parts of the system, mainly on the LMS system, because obviously they were only sort of designed at the very tail end of the Caledonian Railway's actual existence. So they worked mainly on ex-Caledonian lines, but they didn't really survive very long because, unfortunately, they were bad steamers. So it's a bit unfortunate, really, because I think it's a very handsome little locomotive, but, again, they didn't survive very long when they were, you know, poor steamers. So we're going to have a look at the engine, we're going to have a look at it, and we're going to take it out for a little run on the Castleman's Railway because, you know, why not? So what do you get with the pack? So, you get three liveries. Yep, I know it sounds a bit small, but this is the realistic liveries you get with it. So you get the Caledonian Railway blue with the red lining. You've got the LMS black, and you've got, over there at the far end, you've got the LMS crimson. And that tells you a lot about how long they lasted, because they didn't last into World War II, I don't think. And they certainly didn't get up to British Railway days, which is a real shame, because I think they're a handsome little engine, like I said earlier. But if they were poor steamers, then be poor steamers. So, we're going to have a look around, we're going to take it for a drive, and first of all, I have to say that I'm a bit of a fan of these, mainly because I believe this is the first engine that Chris has released for TS that has outside wall shafts valve gear. Now, I can't actually think of any other engines he's done that has outside wall shafts valve gear yet. Technically speaking, I'm going to claim that mine was first, because Rick, it's the first loco that Chris has made with Wolfshard's valve gear, but this is the first one he's released. Isn't it, Chris? Putting blooming horrible SCP things in his packs now. There's one of them somewhere on this route, and I'll point it out to you guys later. So, looking at the locomotive, back on topic, obviously, because I just sort of went off on a bit of a tangent. So, I don't know, there's something about it I really like. I think it's just literally because it's a 460 with outside gear. And it's just, I don't know, I think it's very handsome. What do you guys think? I don't know, I just really like it. I also really like the Caledonian blue livery on it, because obviously it's got the light blue, but it's also got the red cylinder covers and the red lining on the sides. So, as far as I'm concerned, this is one of my favourite liveries. I'm never a big fan of the LMS black, but the crimson one is a very close second. So, let's have another little look around. Now, there are some things I want to say, and these are constructive criticisms, because I've been looking around this model for a little bit. So, mainly, the only problem I've got is with the Westinghouse pump there. Now, take with one hand, give with the other sort of deal here, which is that Chris has produced for us a 460 with outside wall shafts gear, and it looks very lovely, and it's a very handsome engine. But please, Chris, put the animated Westinghouse pumps back in. I liked them, they were cool. I know it's only a little feature, and I don't know whether it's to do with polys or anything like that, or the amount of animations on the locomotive, but that was a cool little feature. And it just seems that, I don't know, it seems that, like, we've got the outside valve gear finally, but we've lost the animated Westinghouse pump. So, yeah, slightly disappointing. The only other thing I can really see on my, because this is obviously a first impression, is just I noticed some little tiny bit around the building plate. Let me just come over here and show you. I mean, it's just a very, very small niggle here, which is just that little wobbliness around the side of the plate. Do you see it? Like the little shadows and things? I don't know. I'm just clutching at straws here, I suppose. Those are just little things. The rest of it, I very much like. Again, I like the design anyway, because it's the final one by Pickersgill. And I must admit, I'm a little bit of a fan of Pickersgill, mainly because, unfortunately, I mean, it's a bit of a sad thing, but William Pickersgill actually passed away in Bournemouth, my hometown. So that's kind of an interesting thing. And also, I just think he sort of made some quite interesting engines. He made big engines for the Caledonian. Like, he made 460s. He made the 462 944 class Pacific tank that Chris has released recently. Well, I say recently, a little while ago. So, yeah, I'm a little bit of a fan of Pickersgill. So this is sort of ticks a lot of my boxes. It's a 460 valve gear. It's a cute little engine. It's got nice, vibrant liveries. Because as you can see over here, we've got the crimson and we've got the slightly less shiny, but also very well applied LMS black. So the liveries, yeah, they're fine. You only get three of them, I'm afraid. But these are, you know, realistic for the locomotive and the class. So you get the LMS black, you've got the Caledonian blue, and then you've got the LMS crimson. Because as I said earlier on, these did not pass into British Railways, which is a shame, because I think these would have been quite good. But as I also previously said, if they were poor steamers, then be poor steamers. See, the thing as well I find with them is they look a little bit like a Mortsel Yuri, well, actually more Yuri S15, you know, with the way the running plate raises at the front and then, I don't know. And also the small driving wheels, I noticed that as well. I suppose that's because if they were built for Scottish routes, like the Callander and Oban line, or designed for them anyway, with those in mind, they had to have smaller driving wheels despite being passenger engines primarily, so they can climb hills and things. So we'll have to see what this thing performs like, because I haven't actually driven it properly yet. I've just been looking at it because it's so pretty. So without having to sound too much like a dick sucker, sorry everyone, and sorry Chris, but yeah, apart from the Westinghouse pump, I mean, the only other thing I've got, I suppose, is going to be the fact that the coal load doesn't go down. But, you know, Chris builds a lot of these locos, he builds a lot. He does spend a lot of his time building these things. And for what you could consider a sort of like a new developer, he's only been releasing things for 2 years now. He's come a very long way, I think. So, I hate sounding like that dick sucky guy, but you know, at least we've got someone who's consistently releasing steam engines for this game, and that's what we like. We like steam engines on this channel. Here at DDJP, we value our steam engines. Even though I know you've got the likes of Richard Works and Bossman Games who release theirs as well, theirs sort of seem to take a lot longer to develop, whereas Chris just sort of goes and then releases them. So I've had a look around the locos. I suppose I should click on one and have a look at the cabin stuff, shouldn't I? So we just clicked on it. I think it has the normal Caledonian whistles. I think there's a couple of new sounds on this loco, and I think a couple of the sounds have taken off a Black 5. So this makes me very happy. I think it was Eric Treacy on the North York Moors. I think it was done by Chris Eden Green, but I don't know. I'm not an expert, as you guys know. As much as I'd like to pretend to be an expert sometimes. So I'm just going to turn the sounds up a minute, so we can have a look around the engine and listen to the sounds. I do like that air pump thumping sound. Because of course these things are air braked. So let's release them again, listen to the mysterious ticking sound. I do like that. So here we are in the cab. It's a cab. So what have we got in here? We've got a Bardic lamp, so you can light up if you're in TSX mode. If you're not in TSX mode, but you'd like to run the engine anyway and have some better performance, then performance mode's got you lit with skip pig as usual. So that turns off the point lights in here. So in case you need to, you know, run it on a low effect machine. So we're going to have a look at the cab views. So obviously we've got this one down here, which I think I will definitely be using a bit. We've got the front one, which I still think is slightly off centre. Chris, there you go. That's what it should be. I suppose that's another criticism I should throw at it. Again, I'm literally clutching at straws because you know what I'm like, and also, you know, as Chris is a mate, I don't really want to upset him, but I have to be sort of critical on these because, you know, I'm getting these things for free, so gotta be a critic. Gotta be a critic. Besides, I love his stuff anyway, it's nice, and also I'm hoping that I'm helping him by showing these things off, and hopefully people will have a look at these. Because at the end of the day, I think he deserves it, really. Especially the amount of crap he has to put up with half the time. But anyway, that's another story. Ooh, should we blow the whistle? So there's a couple of the same whistle sounds that we're used to, but there's a couple of new ones too. I don't know what it is about the modelling, but I like the grimy safety valves, that's cool. Anyway, carrying on. So we're back in the cab again, and I've just noticed something else. I'll show you in a sec. It had the same window designs as the Class 34 that we looked at. The Mogul. You know, it's got those sort of, I don't know how you pronounce, like how you describe the shape, but if we look from, hang on, let's go to here and look back. They sort of have that teardrop shape, I suppose. Would you say teardrop? I don't know. But anyway, I think maybe we should think about giving this thing a little drive now. We've had a look at the engine itself. I haven't really looked at the other two locos, have I? But now, yeah, we'll have a look at them another day because I'm pretty sure that this is going to be another engine that I enjoy driving. I'm probably going to enjoy driving it more. Although, as people have been joking with me recently, I seem to, every time Chris releases a loco, it becomes my favourite thing in the world. But this is like a Scottish S15, so that's why I kind of like it. Also, for anyone wondering, yes, there's the Bible. I found it. Hee hee. So, shall we set up a path, head over to the station, pick up some coaches, and go for a little bit of a run? Now, I will point out that this is like the fifth time as well that I've tried to run this and record this. Because, one, it is like 1 o'clock in the morning where I am, on a Saturday night of all things. And I should really be in bed. However, I was so excited when I saw this thing in my email inbox when I was at work. I was like, you know what? I'm going to have to give it a go. So after I picked my wrath up, I decided, you know what? I might give it a go, but I wasn't going to go to bed. I was in bed, and then my office was like, oh, you don't have to go to bed if you don't want. And I was like, oh, I'll get up and record this then. I'm not even tired yet, to be quite honest, which is kind of annoying because I would have liked to sleep. But, you know, work comes. You get things coming to your inbox. Work has got to work, yo. Anyway, enough of me chatting. I'm going to turn the sounds up a wee bit more, and we're going to give a listen while we go to the station. So, here we go. Look at that, beautiful. It literally is a blue S15, isn't it, boys and girls? Anyway, let's go into the cab and have a listen while we're in there. And have a look at the cab view while it's on the move. Thank you. going down to check something. Franklin do move around, that's nice. Anyway. Oh, that's right, I took that whole blessed CP thing out so I didn't have to look at it. Anyway, he's put like a really horrible SCP thing in the pack, which is like a big white thing, like with blood all over it. And I don't really know why you keep doing it, Chris. Please stop. I don't know what your fascination is at the moment with the SCP, but please stop. I suppose now, while I'm walking over to the station, well, walking, rolling over to the platform, I should mention something that you guys might be interested in if you're part of the Facebook group or whatever. I kind of off camera today. For anybody who's actually interested in picking up something from Chris, aka Caledonia Works, if you're wanting to sort of test something, see whether you like it or not, Chris has released the first piece of DLC he ever made, which is the Caledonia Railway 123 by Drummond. The Cali single, the one that's preserved, that he has released for free on his website at caledoniaworks.com. I hope I got that right. I probably didn't. caledoniaworks.com, caledoniaworks.com, I hope it's caledoniaworks.com. So, if you want to sort of try one of Chris's locos but can't afford one yet or don't want to pay for one quite yet, I'd definitely go over to his website and have a look at picking up the 123 at least, because then you can at least have a trial run and see whether you like them. And that is celebrating 2 years of Caledonia Works products. So Chris kindly decided to give that out for free. So if you wanted to give it a look, I think you should. Personally, I hope people do go and have a look, because they might find, oh, actually I quite like this, and maybe think about supporting Chris by purchasing some of his models. As much as I'd like to be a bit more helpful with that, I mean, I'm a bit hard up for money anyway, for one thing, so it's very nice of Chris to send me these so that I can give them a little test and show everyone them. But yeah, just go give Chris some support. He works hard. He works hard on his locomotives. It is his full-time job after all. God, this is such a beautiful little engine. I kind of want to give it a bigger tender though. I might have to see what the Cardian tender looks like with it. Let's just make sure that you're not going to crash into those coaches. Oh, it's so pretty! Maybe I was a little bit premature with that. Where are the coaches? Oh, they're only there. So we're going to give it a loaded test run, because I will point out this is the one that is currently residing on the Castleman's Railway. I already bagsied it when I heard the 194 was coming out, so 191 even. So we've now got we've got number 193, because it's one of the longest lasting ones. Bump! Very thirsty loco, I must say. Anyway, I'm going to sit back. I'm going to shut up for a bit, and we're going to have some lovely shots of the 191 going along. So, yeah, I'm just moving the camera, and let's watch her depart from Wimborne on the Castleman's Railway. So, here we go. as you guys can tell, this is a pretty big loaded test run because he's taking Grampians. So let's see how it does on the inclines and stuff up to Ringwood and Dape Hill. Back to being shushed. So here we are at Ringwood and Dape Hill, which is obviously a fictional station on my route. So that is the Caledonian 191. I must admit, I am incredibly impressed, and I'm going to continue driving it for a bit because it is a lovely. And of course, I'm quite impressed with how quickly it got up to 40 miles, nearly 50 miles an hour then. So, bad steamer? Maybe. Pretty? Absolutely. I think it is anyway. But certainly not a slouch, especially with the length of the train we decided to take. So, that was the 191. I think I'll probably be doing some more stuff with it at some point. I must admit, I'm very much enjoying the colour scheme, so I'll let you guys know what I think more of it in the future. So we're going to call this Yuri Scotland, I think, or S15 Scotland, stealing Anthony's thing. So we're going to watch it disappear into the distance. Thank you guys all for watching. Again, if you like it, go buy it. It's a very good loco. I know you only get free liveries, but there are reskinners out there. And if you want to go try the 123 and see whether you actually like Chris's stuff, it's free on his website, so you're welcome. So, without further ado, thanks everyone for watching. I'm going to disappear off into the sunset with my new choo-choo train.